TSMC is the world's largest independent semiconductor foundry. It has a 50% share in the market. They supply fabless chip designers like Apple, Nvidia, Qualcomm, and AMD. There's been a lot of press and interest recently in its work. But TSMC has its own suppliers too. These are the people who make the super cutting-edge machines that TSMC operates 24/7. Dutch multinational ASML is TSMC's most important supplier and the maker of the EUV equipment critical to its N7 Plus and N5 processes. In this video, I'm going to profile this rather obscure company and examine its relationship with TSMC. I'll also help answer the question of who is more important so that the fanboys can better score points against each other on internet boards. Face off, who matters more? Spoiler alert, they both matter a whole lot to each other. But first, I want to take the time to ask you to subscribe to the Asianometry newsletter. Getting tired of me saying the same thing over and over again? It's not even like I have a sponsor. Recently, I just finished up a newsletter about the Han migration from mainland China to Taiwan over the span of the last 300 or 400 years. I also added a small essay at the beginning, talking a little bit about the meaning of identity and geographical and sub-national identity. You can find the link to the newsletter in the video description below, or you can just go to asianometry.com. Subscribe and I'll try to make it worth your while. You can expect a new newsletter every 4 days at 1 a.m. Taiwan time. Much thanks. So what is ASML? ASML is a leading provider of advanced technology systems for the semiconductor industry. The company was founded in 1984 as a joint venture between Dutch firms ASM International and Philips. ASML's first machine, the PAS2000 stepper, was released in 1985. A stepper is a device, kind of like a slide projector, that projects a design onto a silicon wafer. ASML would subsequently make over 50 versions of this machine. For the first 10 years of its existence, the company struggled to compete in the semiconductor lithography space, which is a niche. The semiconductor supplier industry faced immense challenges as the economy went through various booms and busts. It was very competitive. ASML lost money for the first 6 years of its life, and in 1990 it would be spun out as an independent company. 2 years later, in 1991, ASML comes out with its first hit product, an I-line stepper. I-line meaning that the stepper uses the 365 nanometer light wavelength. This lets foundries print smaller designs and continue to push Moore's law forward. The product's success allowed ASML to go IPO in 1995, raising money for further product development. After acquiring a few American lithography companies, the company grew into an oligopoly alongside Japanese firms Nikon and Canon. Then came the mid-2000s, where a pair of big product launches allowed ASML to take the lead. In 2006, ASML developed and released its TwinScan system. This machine offered a process optimization feature that helped foundry customers etch more wafers in the same amount of time. Nikon and Canon could not replicate this technology, and it gave ASML its first market share lead over the Japanese. The second big move came with a generational shift in photolithography machinery techniques called immersion lithography. Roughly speaking, it uses water as a lens to shrink the wavelength of the wafer etching laser. Yeah, it sounds nuts, but this technique, discovered by Taiwanese scientist Bern Lin, that's really his name, in the 1980s, helped keep Moore's law alive for a little longer without needing to further shrink the light wavelength. This helped cement ASML's 83% market share. But the industry and ASML continued to think about what could be the next great revolutionary technology in the semiconductor production space. ASML started an R&D office and began investing millions of euro into R&D. I discussed a bit of ASML's work in extreme ultraviolet lithography in a previous video of mine. I'm not going to tell the same story a second time, so you can go watch that whenever you have the time. Instead, I want to tell the same story, but from a different perspective. like Tenet. In 2003, the industry moved forward with the idea of using EUV for the next generation of lithography tools. This decision at the time was controversial and heavily debated. EUV at the time did not have any theoretical blockers. It wasn't a time travel DeLorean or a faster than light energy drive after all. But there were significant challenges of all sorts to getting it up to speed. For instance, the light source would have to be entirely redesigned from the ground up. End user customers like Intel, Samsung, and TSMC would have to retool their fabs. And it's not like that's easy to do. Some argued that current techniques like immersion lithography and another thing called multi-patterning could carry the industry forward. After all, so many things are not working out when it came to EUV, developing it could turn out to be a money pit. Why shoot for a unicorn? Make what already works better. ASML was fortunate to be in a position to try and do both things. They continued development in EUV, but invested to retain a leadership role in current techniques. From 2008 to 2014, ASML as a company invested 4.6 billion euro in R&D. Over time, by 2010, the industry's big players like TSMC, Intel, and Samsung came to believe that EUV could be brought to fruition. ASML saw an opportunity to steal Intel from its previous main supplier, Nikon. Thus, in 2012, ASML announced a customer co-investment scheme where Intel received ownership of 15% of ASML in exchange for $4.1 billion. The money would help develop future tools like EUV. For some reason, Intel did not ask for product exclusivity, something that raised a few eyebrows at the time. This allowed TSMC and Samsung to also buy in later on. The money and the customer buy-in it represented gave ASML breathing room to work out all the kinks, of which there were many. In 2016, the first EUV devices were shipped out of the Netherlands, 30 years after its concepts were first explored. The technology had been delayed for over 10 years after its 2007 prototypes were first delivered, but now it was ready to go. I think what was interesting is how the semiconductor industry's major players banded together to invest and collaborate towards a final finished technology that they would all share in. These companies, ordinarily fierce competitors, saw the threat of not having anything ready for the future and decided to work together, in harmony. ASML could not have finished EUV without intimate participation and financing from its customers. These customers invested billions of euro into the product development process, aware that they would not see the results of their investment for many years. Without this buy-in, ASML would have ended up like Canon, unable to sustain this decades-long odyssey without going bankrupt. We should acknowledge that. On a side note, recently the US government has intervened to prevent the export of ASML's EUV machines to China. I have seen some people asking on what grounds the United States has in restricting the export of EUV. After all, ASML is a Dutch company, and last time I checked, the Netherlands is not an American state. Additionally, in 2012, the ASML CEO then had said, "We welcome Intel as the first customer to agree to contribute to these investments in semiconductor equipment, the results of which will be available to every semiconductor manufacturer with no restrictions." Read my lips, no restrictions. So what gives? This is because EUV is literally an American-founded technology. Think of EUV as a startup and the US as its controlling shareholder. It's Mark Zuckerberg, so to say. EUV LLC was founded by American semiconductor firms Intel and Micron in 1997 to partner with the US Department of Energy to commercialize its EUV studies. EUV LLC invested $250 million over 30 years at the early stages and as a result receives royalties on all EUV revenues. In February 1999, ASML negotiated for and received a license from EUV LLC for its EUV technologies. Back in 1999, long before ASML would come out with the products that won at the market, Japanese companies Nikon and Canon still had 54% share of the semiconductor lithography market. ASML had 34%. There was no American player. Had there been, I believe they would have received this license first. The EUV LLC participation allowed ASML to leapfrog the Japanese's progress in EUV and get that critical first buy-in from major customers like Intel, TSMC, and Samsung. Canon and Nikon did not receive a license and eventually declined to develop EUV to the same degree. Canon in 2007 due to financial issues, like I said. Nikon because they pursued the continued evolution of older techniques that ended up petering out. Yes, we all agreed that ASML invested immense resources in making EUV the final usable product that it is today. They took a huge risk and swung at the right pitch, ending up to be the right company at the right time. And we agreed that Europeans should not always go along with what America says. Maintaining national sovereignty is very important. But the EUV example to me is more clear-cut than most. Europeans, South Koreans, Indians, Taiwanese, a whole bunch of people contributed to the effort. But America founded and led it. Side note to the side note, I am aware of an EU-backed Euclides program pursuing EUV, but apparently did not seem to be as successful as EUV LLC. And side note to the side note. And if you have worked in a tech startup before, you would know that the founder's say matters the most. So, between TSMC and ASML, who matters more? I got the idea for this video largely because of the nationalist internet food fight that tends to flare up every time TSMC appears in the news. You have a choir of comments which immediately sing, but they all depend on ASML, which is Dutch, which in turn triggers talk of ASML's American subsidiaries and so on. Setting immature nationalism aside, the actual question is a good one to ask. In my opinion, good questions help you to get a better understanding of the situation at hand. Let us use a metaphor. Semiconductor foundry work, it's like baking a pound cake. You have raw materials. You need to process them together in special ways over many steps, for which you use specialized equipment. An oven by Middleby, for instance, or a blender by Hamilton Beach, to process these materials into a final product. You can liken TSMC to the baker in the kitchen. ASML is like Middleby here, providing the high-tech oven. The baking of a cake is just one step out of many, a critical one for sure, but if you focus too much on it, then you ignore the importance of stirring together the flour and the eggs, as well as applying the creamy frosting to give it that extra deliciousness. Your cake might suck. Same with microchips. Lithography is a critical step in the final development, but there's many more steps that need to be finished off before the final chip is ready to be put into a computer or graphics card. Packaging and testing, for instance. Otherwise, it's still just a chunk of silicon. This makes intuitive sense when you think about the progress made by other companies using ASML's same EUV machines. TSMC has the most EUV machines in the world, but Intel and Samsung also got substantial numbers of the same machines. Intel was literally the lead investor in making EUV happen. Neither of those foundries are at the same level of yield and output. Cooking skills and experience matter, as my sucky cakes can attest. When the customer sits down to the final product, they see and enjoy a cake. Can you attribute a percentage quote-unquote credit of the cake's deliciousness to the eggs and the flour from which it was made? To the heat coming out of the oven in which it was baked, to the skill of the cook who baked it. You can try, but it all ends up in a ridiculous exercise of numbers pulled out of your butt. Because the reality is they all came together in a single harmonious moment to give you this amazing thing. All right, everyone, take care of yourselves. Stay safe.